在前面的两次课当中，我们对这个故事进行了逐段逐句的精讲，学习了超多地道实用的表达。那么这一次课，我们就会就一个知识点进行非常全面细致的展开，也就是对比王昭君和梅花。我们上一节课啊，其实对王昭君跟梅花已经做了一个初步的对比，但这一次课呢，我们会更加全面、深入、细致的去剖析其中的一些细节。也希望通过这节课的学习，大家能够学会如何对比两个不同的对象。 OK, now let's get started. 从我们的课文我们了解到，昭君在去世之后，她的灵魂化作了梅花，回到了故乡，并且被人们奉为梅花的花神。 The legend goes that after her death, Wang Zhaojun returned to her homeland in the form of a plum blossom, and she was deified as the official patron of the plum blossom by the Chinese people.Deify, 动词神话。那么他为什么会被神化呢？这是人们把对昭君的赞美啊寄托于梅花的种种品格之上。This is a way that people express their admiration for Zhao Jun by identifying her characteristics with the virtues and spirit of this blossom. Virtues, 名词，高尚的道德、正直的品性等等。那么问题来了，人们为什么会把王昭君和梅花联系在一起，而不是别的花呢？这是因为他们之间有诸多共同之处。我们之前已经初步的对比了一下他们的共同点。今天呢，为了让大家更深入的理解这个话题，我总结了一个 ACA 关键词。The first A stands for appearance, 外观。王昭君's appearance was said to be strikingly like that of the plum blossom. 据说啊，王昭君有和梅花一样不俗的容貌。那我们就先来看一下梅花。When blooming, plum blossoms are just like numerous snowflakes, with a noble and elegant character. They possess a striking beauty in the freezing and desolate atmosphere of the winter. Desolate 就是荒凉的。就是说啊，梅花开放之时，繁如瑞雪，孤傲淡雅。在寒冬的一片萧素之中啊，尤为美丽动人。哎，我们来看一下昭君又是什么样的。Similarly, Zhao Jun was one of the four great beauties of ancient China. She was extremely beautiful, had a lofty character, and was dignified and graceful. 昭君则是中国的古代的四大美女之一，花容月貌，气质高贵，端庄得体。举止优雅，可见在这一点上，梅花和昭君确实是非常像的。我们之前提过的一个成语“沉鱼落雁”，其中的“落雁”就是用来形容昭君的美貌。传说啊，天上的大雁看到昭君的容貌的时候，已经忘记扇动翅膀，所以掉到地上。哎，那么这段话这个典故用英语怎么说呢？我们一起来看一下 ，The Chinese idiom。A dazzling beauty that makes the wild geese fall is often used to describe her gorgeous appearance. Her beauty makes the geese forget to flap their wings and fall to the ground. 所以啊，昭君和梅花有着一样惊世的容貌。Therefore, Zhao Jun had the same stunning and striking beauty as the plum blossom. 这是他们的第一个共同点，就是外在的美。接下来我们来看一下 ACA 里面的 C, 就是 characteristics, 品质。我们来对比一下梅花和王昭君之间的一些共同的品质。我们来先看梅花。The plum blossom, a gentleman among flowers, has always been especially appreciated for its hardihood to withstand the bone-piercing cold of winter. 梅花是花中的君子，尤其因为它能够忍受刺骨的寒冷。而备受人们赞誉。我们来看一下它的表现，和其他花做一些对比。While other flowers bloom only in spring and summer, the plum blossom alone blooms in winter. In fact, the colder it is, the more luxuriantly the plum blossom blooms, and the sturdier its spirit. 其他的花都是在春夏开放，只有梅花在冬季开放，并且天气越寒冷，它开得越饱满。越精神。到这里啊，大家有没有想到昭君的哪个特质跟梅花的这种品质特别相似呢？好，我们一起来看一下。Likewise, Zhao Jun volunteered to marry the Xiongnu leader in a distant and bleak land. which is a horrible and scary thing, while other palace mates were reluctant to do so. 昭君为了国家的黎民百姓，在别的宫女都退缩的情况下，他自告奋勇远嫁匈奴，而远嫁匈奴这件事本身就是特别令人畏惧的一件事，但是他做到了，可见他非常的勇敢，与众不同。王昭君 braved the harsh life of a far-off land, conquering her own fears about leaving home. 昭君呢，不怕塞外这种艰苦的生活环境，也克服了自己对远离家乡的这种恐惧。So, we can say that the noble character, fearless of hardship, is the mutual virtue of 昭君 and the plum blossom. 所以我们可以说啊，不畏艰难，这种品质是昭君和梅花共有的品质，这是他们的第二个共同点。最后一个字母就是 ACA 当中的第二个 A, achievement,指的是他们的贡献或者说成就也极为相似。我们先来看一下梅花。It is also a fact that plum blossoms flourish in cold winter, acting as the messenger of spring. Their blooming indicates that the warm and beautiful spring is about to come. 我们还可以看到啊，梅花在寒冬盛开，它是春天的使者。它们的盛开意味着美丽温暖的春天即将到来。我们来看一下昭君。In a similar way, 昭君 was the peace envoy sent from the Han Dynasty to the Xiongnu, melting the ice that hindered the development of the two nations' friendship. 而昭君作为和平的使者，融化了阻碍两国关系发展的这个坚冰，贡献也非常伟大。Thanks to her sacrifices and efforts, the two nations maintain a peaceful status for over half a century.Without any warfare, it was Zhao Jun who brought the spring of communication and cooperation between the two nations. 因为昭君的付出和努力，两个国家就是匈奴和汉朝，他们之间呢存在了长达半个世纪的和平时期，没有任何战争。正是昭君给两个民族带来了交往合作的春天。好的，这里我们回头复习一下我们的 ACA 这个结构 Appearance, Characteristics, and Achievements 希望通过这个结构大家不仅能够更加深刻清晰地了解王昭君和梅花之间的共同点更能学会如何去对比两个不同的对象我们可以从外在、内在和影响三个角度进行对比大家活学活用用到我们实际的口语、写作和其他的方面那接下来我们来换一个主题。我们刚才谈到的昭君是古代身上拥有梅花品质的人。那么现代生活当中有没有这样的人呢？其实很多，对吧？我们来谈一下这个话题。那么在现代的中国啊，我们一次又一次的看到甘愿为国家或者人民这个牺牲付出的中国人。In modern China, we have seen individuals who are willing to sacrifice in the interests of their nation and people.有哪些人呢？我们来举一些例子。例如，在1998年长江洪水中不惧危险抢救灾民的士兵。Okay, everyone, that's everything for this lesson. I believe you have got a lot more out of this story, especially you have learned how to compare two different subjects from different aspects.
大家学会了如何从不同的角度去对比两个不同的对象。我们今天说的 ACA 这个对比方法呢，只是其中的一个参考方法。
大家要学以致用，举一反三。I personally believe this story is a little bit sad, but quite inspiring at the same time.
这个故事有点伤感，但同时呢，又非常鼓舞人心。
In the next episode, I will be giving some of my ideas about how this story relates to the modern world. Okay, so see you next time. Bye.